Investors, commercial bankers, private industry executives, and investment managers will at some point have to deal with the growing importance of environmental, social, and governance factor as part of their work. In this podcast, I'll be discussing the fundamental knowledge you need to effectively respond to such inquiries and to make better use of ESG data when performing due diligence and investing. At the end of this episode, you would have learned about ESG and how it is used to evaluate risk, reward, and achieve effective management. Before delving into some key considerations for corporations and investors alike, I'll talk about how stakeholder expectations affect corporate ESG action. I do have a unique perspective on the importance and relevance of ESG across industries, functional areas, and stakeholder groups because of my experience in advancing ESG progress from C-suite to the facility associate level. And when it comes to assessing a company's impact on its stakeholders' well-being, ESG refers to environmental, social, and governance. Environmental criteria refer to a company's environmental stewardship, which includes how it manages the environmental impact of its operations, its product, and other business activities. In the context of social criteria, a company's value creation is measured in terms of how it serves its stakeholders. In the end, the term governance refers to how a business is led and run. ESG is a framework of evaluating a company's risk and opportunity management in face of changing market and non-market conditions. A company's entire landscape is impacted by this shift in natural systems, social systems, and economic systems. Even though ESG can touch on social conscious concepts, in the end, ESG is not just about morality. ESG focuses on the ability to create and sustain long-term value in a rapidly changing marketplace, in an economy and a worldwide managing the risk and opportunities associated with these changes. It's important to keep in mind that there is no single ESG issue classification. As a company grows and evolves, so does its definition of what constitutes an issue and how it categorizes and communicated to the public. When it comes to hiring practices, community involvement, or procurement strategies, some companies and investors consider diversity, equity, and inclusion to be a social issue that needs to be dealt with. Having a more diverse board, for example, and a workforce, however, is seen by some as an issue of corporate governance that is critical to making better decisions, stimulating innovations, and aiding in acquiring new customers or targeting a particular market. Because of this lack of consistency, you as an analyst must be able to dissect problems and determine how they might affect results and the profitability of the company you work for. Corporate social responsibility and sustainability are often used interchangeably, but ESG is far more important than just CSR. So let's take a deeper look at the origins of ESG before we get into specifics. It was the development of subsequent compliance and environmental employee regulations that actually laid the foundations for the development of environmental health and safety as a concept of social sustainability, or a company's approach to minimizing its negative environmental impact beyond what was legally required. The concept of corporate social responsibility was introduced by a way for companies to address social issues as part of their sustainability effort. CSR was founded on the principles of corporate philanthropy and employee volunteerism. So competitive advantage, greater risk and reward management, and ESG has evolved into a more holistic concept in the 2020s. Taking a deeper look at ESG issues and how they affect business now, the question to ask ourselves is, how did environmental, social, and governance become such a popular business concept? Three factors have led to the rise of ESG. Investors and academics alike are becoming increasingly aware that that ESG factors influence risk and return for investors. Another factor is the desire of customers to want to know how their money is being invested. And finally, regulation has played a significant role, you know, particularly in the wake of the 2008 financial crisis. It is widely agreed that the corporate sector plays an important role in both contributing to and addressing global public threats such as climate change and human rights violations. A Dutch appeal court, for instance, ruled that the Nigerian branch of oil giant Shell is responsible for damage caused by leaks in the Niger Delta. The court ordered Shell Nigeria to pay compensation to Nigerian farmers, while the subsidiary and its Anglo-Dutch parent company were told to install equipment to prevent further future damage. A group of farmers launched this case in the year 2008, alleging widespread pollution, even though Shell says the leak were a result of sabotage. Even though the ruling can be appealed against, the judgment could have implications beyond Nigeria, and which is in terms of its corporate responsibility and duty of care multinationals have to the people in the places where they operate. A total of 4 billion euros in penalties and fines were imposed on Volkswagen in 2015 for cheating emission tests in 11 million diesel vehicles. And in 2013, Cambridge Analytica vested the personal data of almost 87 million Facebook users, resulting in Facebook losing billions of dollars in market value. The data was collected without users' consent, predominantly to be used for political advertising. The cost of compensation, the cleanup cost, and local reparations is a high-profile example of financial and material, environmental, social, and governance incidents that have influenced greater clients' demand for transparency and regulator demand for ESG to be recognized as a fiduciary duty. I am Sunday Clement, and thanks for listening. You may follow me on YouTube by clicking on the subscribe button at the end of this page, so you can be the first to know when I upload new videos.